I like when the opponent just sits there and lets this happen, like they're doing the math in their head. Like, you don't have me dead yet. How are you gonna attack? By giving them all haste. Welcome back everyone, it's Untap Your Go, and today we'll be playing the Neoform combo in Historic. This is a deck I saw online posted by Ginky. I don't know if this is the original source, but he has a really detailed article about it with a primer and a sideboard guide in full detail of the card selection and everything. So since this is the best of three version and we're going to be playing best of one in today's video, I'm going to switch over to the best of one version that I took from this list. This is the best of one version and you'll notice right away that all four Pact of Negations are from the sideboard into the main board. This is so we can push our combos through removal and counterspells. For those who don't understand the combo, I'll break it down. You need 4 mana, a Seagate Stormcaller, and a Neoform. You cast Seagate Stormcaller first, and then you cast Neoform, and a copy goes on the stack. You tutor up Dual Caster Mage, which copies Neoform, puts another copy on the stack, and then you just keep grabbing Dual Caster Mages until you run out. Once you run out of Dual Caster Mage, you grab Glasspool Mimic, coming in as a copy of Dual Caster Mage. Once you get to the last copy of Glasspool Mimic, you tutor up Tuk Tuk Rubble Fort for haste and Combat Celebrant to give your creatures additional combat step. And that's the deck. I'll leave a link down in the description if you want to try out this version, as well as a link to the original primer where I got this deck list from. And all credits go to Ginky for coming up with this list. Leave a like on today's video if this deck was interesting or if you found it insightful. And please consider subscribing to the channel if you're not a subscriber already, and hit the bell for notifications so you can stay up to date with more content. And with that, let's take it to the arena and see how we do in Historic Best of One Ranked. We are on the play, and although we don't have a Seagate Stormcaller, we do have a Paradise Druid in a Neoform. If we can find a Dual Caster Mage, we'll be fine. This is even better. Alright, opponent decides not to do anything. Since we don't have any form of combo right now, I'm just going to attempt to play Wall of Blossoms and try to draw a card here. Found the Seagate Stormcaller, so we have lethal next turn if our goose lives. Catcher for our opponent. Alright, so Seagate Stormcaller, not kick. Neoform. We'll go ahead and sack the Wall of Blossoms. And now we just grab all of our Dual Caster Mages out of our deck. And you grab all your Glasspool Mimics, targeting all of your Dual Caster Mages. And then you grab Combat Celebrant, the final copy resolves, get Tuk Tuk Rubble Fort for haste, and swing. Now, I didn't exert the Combat Celebrant this turn, but I don't think the math actually matters. I haven't seen enough. We don't have a green source. And we don't have a Seagate Stormcaller, so I'm probably going to pitch this. And this is pretty good. Back one of the Glasspool Mimics. Right like that. Up against... So far, our shield. Archfiend's Vessel and not a Lore's deck. Mono Black Devotion, Vampires. Gets the life. Good for action here. We don't need another goose. Play a glass pool. Radiant Fountain for our opponent. They're gonna gain some life. Sorry, it's Dorfman. So this is just like a. Small mono black area there. Cool. Same thing, we're just gonna block the ocean. Alright, we found Neoform. Now we need mana. We dig for a land of Shimmer. Alright, so I'll play the Cry Crown as the red. Go ahead and get the card as Druid into play. If they kill the beast, that's fine. You just need a land. We're taking three more. Alright, that's not a land. So for now, we're just gonna run out our creatures. So we're at a virtual one, assuming we block everything. Actually, maybe not, because we can't activate Veto. This box here. Here. Block like that and see how it goes. I'm at one. Can opponent gain one more life this turn? They cannot. We might have it. We got there from one. Right, we're up against half-eaten bread, and we have the combo in hand. We're going to lead off with the Glasspool Mimic. Try to set up for a turn 4 kill. Up against mono red. Got another Neoform. Both our Tuk Tuk Rebel Fords are in our hand, so that's not good. We'll have to hard cast it. Which honestly, I don't mind playing it this turn. Tuk Tuk Rebel Fort having reach is pretty good. Alright, so we didn't draw an untapped source, so we're gonna have to play it this way. Out our other rubble fort just in case. Annex for opponent. Sure, I'll block it. The opponent has all their creatures on standby ready. Still gonna go for the combo. Two dual caster mages in her hand too. And two Glasspool Mimics. It's pretty unfortunate. We're gonna play it like this. Our opponent's gonna block, but all of our creatures that survive this combat are gonna get an additional combat. Nice from our opponent. And then we'll go ahead and exert this one and get final attack. Good game, opponent. And we have the combo in hand, so we're gonna keep it. Alakid Awakening is not a bad draw for us. We can play that as a land. It'd be nice to put back the Dualcaster Mage, but we should have enough. Paradise Druid having Hexproof gives us protection from them targeting our creature, and we should have enough to combo off next turn. Ooh, Pwn did not have a mutate to follow up with. This is turn three for us. I'll actually sacrifice the Paradise Druid so I can attack with the Seagate Stormcaller. It's like one of the fastest combo decks I've ever seen on Arena. When it realizes there's nothing they can do. Opponent's on the play, and we have our combo. You know what that means. We're gonna win on turn four. We could potentially see a Thoughtseize from our opponent. Drawing in a Rebel Fort's not great. I think I'll actually play out the Combat Celebrant because if we, for some reason, get dealt with like a Thoughtseize or something. We can just start getting in with this. Opponent Extinction Event to Combat Celebrant. So that leaves us wide open. Game opponent. I like when the opponent just sits there and lets this happen, like they're doing the math in their head. Like, you don't have me dead yet. I'm still not dead. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. It's only 15. Well, wait, that's 18. I'm still not dead, though. How are you gonna attack? By giving them all haste. Soon as he sees the haste outlet, over. Over. Hey everyone, welcome back to the wrap-up. If you've made it this far, thank you for watching. Today we went 5-0 for a pretty astonishing finish, and I gotta say, the deck is pretty fast. Like, winning on turn 4 pretty consistently, turn 3 sometimes on the fast hands, absolutely crazy. Like, Neoform is a card that's most likely gonna get banned, so if you have the cards to try this out, highly recommend it. You're going to get a lot of easy ranks with this. So anyway, thanks for watching, everyone. I'll leave a link down in the description for the original primer if you want to check that out, as well as a link to this version of the deck that I took from that list. And please consider leaving a like on this video. I want to try to get 10 on today's video. Also, consider subscribing if you haven't already and hit the bell for notifications so you can stay up to date with more kooky decks like this. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll see you next time.